In this video, I will talk about operational amplifier, instrumentation amplifier, and at last I will show you the derivation of equation of output voltage for this instrumentation amplifier circuit. Since long, the electronic engineers have been in quest of universal amplifier that may fit in most of the applications without any serious limitations of gain, stability and impedance matching. The instrumentation amplifier fulfills all these requirements. An instrumentation amplifier is a kind of difference amplifier which has inbuilt input buffers. See, this is a operational amplifier buffer and this is another buffer. So it has inbuilt buffers which eliminate the need of input impedance matching. The instrumentation amplifier is designed to have a very low DC offset, low drift, low noise, very high open loop gain and very high common mode rejection ratio and very high input impedance. See, as the circuit is a buffer circuit, it will have very high input impedance. And we can control the gain of the operational amplifier by using this resistor RG. Here this RG means we can control the gain of this amplifier using this resistor RG. The op amp instrumentation amplifier uses three op amp. See, this is one op amp, this is another op amp and this is another op amp. And we can divide this op amp instrumentation amplifier into two segments. This is the difference amplifier segment and this is the buffer circuit segment. Now let me show you the derivation of this operational amplifier instrumentation amplifier. See, our operational amplifier instrumentation amplifier can be divided into two portions, buffer circuit unit and difference amplifier unit. See, the voltage at this point is, let's say, VO1, and that will be applied at one end of this R2, and the voltage at this end is VO2. When we have a difference amplifier like this with voltage at one terminal V01 and with voltage one terminal V02, we can calculate the output voltage by using this formula. See, this is our output voltage, so this will be the output of the difference amplifier or operational amplifier subtractor. VO will be equal to R3 divided by R2. Into the voltage at this terminal V02 minus the voltage at this terminal V01. Let's say this is our equation number 1. This is the output equation of this difference amplifier. If you don't know anything about difference amplifier, I will request you to check my one of the previous videos regarding this difference amplifier or operational amplifier subtractor circuit. Okay, so this is the output voltage equation. Let's say this is our equation number 1. In this unit we have two buffer circuits. See, this is one buffer and this is another buffer. See, at this non-inverting terminal I am applying a voltage V1 and at this non-inverting terminal I am applying a voltage V2. Let's say the value of this V1 is greater than V2. Now see, this output terminal of this op-amp is connected with the inverting terminal through a resistor R1. When this output terminal will be connected with the inverting terminal, the circuit, this op-amp will be in negative feedback. See, this output terminal is connected with the inverting terminal through this resistor R1. So this op-amp will also be in negative feedback. When an operational amplifier is in negative feedback, its inverting terminal voltage and non-inverting terminal voltages will be equal. That means VP will be equal to VN. See, the voltage at this non-inverting terminal is V2. Therefore, the voltage at the inverting terminal will be V2. Here the non-inverting terminal voltage is V1. Therefore, the voltage at the non-inverting terminal should be V1. See, this is the terminal. So the voltage at this terminal will be V1. And see, this terminal is connected with this point. So the voltage at this terminal will be V2. As the operational amplifiers are in negative feedback, therefore the currents through the inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal will be zero. That means there will be no current flow through this path, or there will be no current flow through this path. Okay, that means as there is no current flow through this path or this path, the same current will flow from this VO01 terminal towards this V0O2 terminal. Now see, I know the voltage at this terminal and this terminal, and I have assumed this V1 is greater than this V2. Therefore, if I assume the current through the resistor, RG is equal to I. I will be flowing in this indicated direction because V1 is greater than V2. That means this terminal will be at higher potential and this terminal will be at lower potential. So I can calculate the current I using this formula. I will be equal to higher voltage V1 minus V2 divided by the resistance RG. Let's say this is our equation number 2. Okay, now see, when this I will enter at this point, it will have two paths to divide. One is in this path and another is through this path. See, the current in this direction will be equal to zero. That means the same current I will flow through the resistor R1. Now see, if I consider this current I is outgoing from this terminal, you will see there will be no current flow through this path because this op amp is in negative feedback, and when an operational amplifier is in negative feedback, inverting terminal current will be zero. So as the current through this path is equal to zero, that means this current I must be incoming from this direction. That means this same current I will flow through the resistor R1 from this terminal towards this terminal. Now if I assume the voltage at this terminal is equal to V01 and the voltage at this terminal is equal to VO2 or V02, you will see this V01 will be at higher potential, or this terminal should be positive and this terminal should be negative, and current always flows from higher potential towards the lower potential. Now I know the voltage difference between this point to this point. As there is no current flow in this direction or in this direction, that means they will act like open circuit. Now see, I know the resistance from this terminal to this terminal, which will be the sum of this R1, RG and this R1, and the voltage difference between this terminal to this terminal. Now if I apply Ohm's law, I will get the current I. Here I am calculating the current from this terminal to this terminal. See, as current is flowing from this direction, so this terminal will be at higher potential and this terminal will be at a lower potential. Now I am applying Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that current will be equal to the voltage difference divided by total resistance of that path. Here you will see the voltage difference will be V01 minus V02. And the total resistance from this terminal to this terminal will be equal to R1 plus RG plus R1 plus RG plus R1, from which I can write V01 minus V02 divided by 2R1 plus RG. See, from equation 2 I can write I equal to V1 minus V2 divided by RG. Now let me put the value of I2 which I have obtained from equation number 2. V1 minus V2 divided by the value of gain resistance. So here I can write V01 minus V02 equal to 2R1 plus RG divided by RG into V1 minus V2. Now see, to calculate the output voltage I have to take VO2 or V02 minus V01. So if I take a minus sign in front of both sides, I will get VO2 minus VO1 equal to, see, I can simplify it like this, 1 plus 2R1 divided by RG into V2 minus V1. Let's say this is our equation number 3. See, from equation 1 I can write VO, output voltage, will be equal to R3 divided by R2 into V02 minus V01. Now let me put the value of V02 minus V01 from the equation number 3. VO equal to R3 divided by R2 into 1 plus 2R1 divided by RG into V2 minus V1. See, this is the output voltage equation of our instrumentation amplifier. Now I will calculate the gain of instrumentation amplifier. See, this is the differential input voltage and this is the output voltage. So if I take the ratio of output voltage and differential input voltage V2 minus V1, I will get the gain of this instrumentation amplifier, which will be equal to R3 by R2 into 1 plus 2R1 by RG. So this is the gain equation of the instrumentation amplifier. Usually the RG is a variable resistor. If I make this RG smaller, I will get a very large gain. If I increase the value of this RG, I will get a very smaller gain. Okay, that's it. Thank you.